Upon seeing it, it struck me that, well, this explains all the UFO sightings. It never even occurred to me, even though I was looking at an extraterrestrial vehicle, that, you know, this wasn't man-made.
The enigmatic Bob Lazar has finally pulled back the curtain on previously concealed UFO evidence.
I got it.
Oh my gosh.
Oh.
What the hell?
As intrigue and speculation run rampant, this video delves deep into the revealed evidence, its implications, and the myriad reactions it has sparked. Bob Lazar, the man behind the reveal. Bob Lazar has always been a subject of much discussion and controversy within the UFO community and beyond. His name, etched in the annals of UFO lore, has been synonymous with allegations of governmental cover-ups, advanced propulsion systems, and the mysterious Area 51.
Did you see that move it did?
No, I didn't.
It went, look at how bright it's getting.
Look at it now.
In understanding the recent disclosure of previously hidden UFO evidence, a closer look at the man himself offers invaluable insights into the weight and context of this revelation. Born in the mid-20th century, Lazara's early life was fairly typical. He showed an intrinsic curiosity about the universe, which paved the way for his future ventures. By the time he completed his formal education, Lazara had developed a profound interest in physics and propulsion systems. This expertise, combined with his intrinsic curiosity, would later set the stage for his controversial involvement with extraterrestrial technology. In the late 1980s, Lazar burst into public consciousness when he claimed to have been employed at a site near Area 51, a top-secret U.S. military installation. This facility, known as S-4, was where, according to Lazara, reverse engineering of alien spacecraft was taking place. He alleged that during his tenure there, he worked directly with extraterrestrial technology, trying to understand and replicate the propulsion systems of these advanced vehicles. The intricacies of these propulsion systems, as described by Lazar, were nothing short of revolutionary. He spoke of Element 115, a then undiscovered element that powered the anti-gravity systems of these UFOs. While many in the scientific community scoffed at this claim, it ignited a firestorm of curiosity among UFO enthusiasts and conspiracy theorists. It's worth noting that years later, element 115, Muscovium, was added to the periodic table, albeit with properties different from what Lazara described. Lazar's revelations were not without consequences. He became the target of intense scrutiny. Critics questioned his educational and professional credentials, his motivations for disclosing such sensitive information, and the veracity of his claims. Despite the criticism, his detailed descriptions of the spacecraft, its mode of operation, and the infrastructure at S4 were compelling enough to keep his story alive and debated for decades. Over the years, Lazar maintained a relatively low profile, occasionally resurfacing to provide clarifications, interviews, or additional details about his experiences. Yet, with this recent disclosure of hidden UFO evidence, he has once again catapulted into the limelight, prompting both longtime followers and new generations to reassess the depth and validity of his claims. Why now? What motivated Lazar to unveil evidence that had presumably been kept under wraps for so long? Some argue it's a matter of timing, suggesting that the global environment is more receptive to the idea of extraterrestrial encounters. Others surmise that Lazara, after years of introspection, felt a moral obligation to share the truth with the world. But perhaps one of the most poignant aspects of Bob Lazar's story is the personal toll it has taken on him. He has spoken on multiple occasions about the challenges of carrying such a profound secret, the isolation from mainstream scientific communities, and the skepticism he faced from friends, family, and colleagues. In many ways, the essence of Bob Lazar is reflected in the dichotomy of his experiences. Here is a man who, on one hand, claims to have interacted with some of the most advanced technologies ever known, yet, on the other, grapples with the very human emotions of doubt, isolation, and the relentless pursuit of truth. As the world now digests the newly revealed UFO evidence, it is essential to remember the man behind the reveal, a complex individual caught at the intersection of curiosity, revelation, and controversy. The previously hidden evidence, an analysis. For years, the UFO community and the general public have been eagerly waiting for tangible evidence that could corroborate claims of extraterrestrial encounters. Bob Lazar's recent disclosure has added a significant chapter to this narrative. This analysis seeks to dive deep into the details of the evidence he presented and unpack its implications. Lazar unveiled a series of photographs and video footage. These visuals, markedly clearer than most previous UFO sightings, depict unidentified aerial phenomena, UAP, performing maneuvers that seem to defy our current understanding of physics. The craft showcased in these materials exhibited no visible means of propulsion, yet they moved with unprecedented speed and agility, stopping mid-air and changing directions instantaneously. Of particular interest is the metallic sheen of the objects, reminiscent of Lazar's descriptions from decades ago. Could this be the same anti-gravitational technology powered by Element 115 that he once spoke of? The clarity of these images and videos offers researchers an unprecedented opportunity to study the physical characteristics of these UAPs in detail. Perhaps even more compelling than the visual evidence are the material samples Lazar provided. Said to be fragments from a crashed UFO, these materials display anomalous properties. Preliminary studies suggest that they are made up of a unique alloy, unlike anything found on Earth. When subjected to specific electromagnetic frequencies, these fragments levitate, seemingly validating Lazar's claims about anti-gravity technology. Accompanying the tangible evidence were a series of documents and recorded testimonies. These video purportedly leaked from high-level governmental sources hint at covert operations and studies related to extraterrestrial technology. Several anonymous testimonies from individuals claiming to have worked at facilities similar to S4 corroborate Lazar's stories. While the authenticity of these documents is still under scrutiny, their level of detail and consistency with Lazar's accounts lends them considerable weight. A set of audio recordings provided sounds that are believed to be interactions between military personnel and the UAPs. These recordings, if authentic, provide insights into how these encounters were handled at the operational level. Distinct commands, observations, and expressions of astonishment can be heard, capturing the tension and awe of such unprecedented encounters. If validated, Lazar's disclosure challenges much of what we understand about technology, physics, and our place in the universe. The revealed technology's potential implications are vast, from revolutionizing transportation and energy sectors on Earth to potentially unlocking interstellar travel. However, the disclosure also raises concerns. If governments have indeed been privy to such groundbreaking technology, their secrecy suggests potential geopolitical ramifications. The technological edge that comes from understanding and possibly replicating UFO tech could be a game changer in global dynamics. As with any such revelation, skepticism is warranted. Many in the scientific community are calling for an independent, transparent investigation into the presented evidence. They argue that while the material and visual evidence is compelling, it is crucial to ensure that they haven't been tampered with or misrepresented. Furthermore, there's the challenge of separating the genuine from the noise. Given the interest that this disclosure has generated, there's a risk of misinformation and fake claims flooding the public domain. Distinguishing authentic evidence from potential hoaxes will be an uphill task. Bob Lazar's disclosure of previously hidden UFO evidence offers tantalizing possibilities. If genuine, humanity might be on the brink of a new era of understanding about ourselves, our technology, and perhaps our neighbors in the cosmos. The evidence demands rigorous scrutiny and open-minded investigation, ensuring that truth, whatever it might be, comes to light. Technological insights, what the UFO shows. Bob Lazar's long-anticipated reveal of hidden UFO evidence provides more than just fodder for extraterrestrial enthusiasts. It offers a glimpse into technologies that, if understood, could redefine our scientific paradigms. Delving into the details, we can attempt to infer the technological marvels encapsulated within the unidentified flying objects he presented. The most immediate and noticeable attribute of the disclosed UFOs is their propulsion system, or more precisely, the apparent lack of one. Traditional aircraft rely on aerodynamic principles, using wings for lift and engines for thrust. In stark contrast, the UFOs in Lazar's evidence move without wings, exhausts, or any visible propulsion mechanism. Their ability to hover, accelerate from a standstill to high speeds, and make sharp turns defies our current aerodynamic understanding. This suggests a technology that can manipulate gravitational forces, essentially making the crafts weightless and allowing for movement in any direction without resistance. Lazar's earlier claims about element 115 inches powering these UFOs' anti-gravity systems may provide a clue. If indeed these crafts employ a propulsion system based on a yet-to-be-understood application of element 115, we're looking at a complete overhaul of propulsion science. Such technology would not only revolutionize aerospace, but could also have applications here on Earth, possibly leading to transportation methods that are faster, more efficient, and environmentally benign. The surface of the UFOs with their metallic sheen hints at advanced material science. They might be constructed from alloys that are not only structurally robust, but perhaps possess adaptive qualities. These materials could potentially react to external stimuli, changing their properties based on environmental conditions or the needs of the craft. For instance, they might become more reflective when exposed to intense heat or radiation, or shift their structure to become more aerodynamic when required. The UFO's seamless design suggests a level of manufacturing precision that is yet unattained in our current technological landscape. There's an absence of rivets, joints, or any signs of assembly. It's as if each craft is made from a single, continuous material. This might indicate advanced fabrication techniques, perhaps on an atomic or molecular level, where materials are grown rather than assembled. Communication and control mechanisms are another area of intrigue. There's no evidence of antennas, satellite dishes, or any traditional communication apparatus on these crafts. Yet, they seemingly operate with intent and purpose, suggesting advanced onboard intelligence or remote communication capability. This might point towards quantum communication methods or other non-localized means of transmitting information, which, when decoded, could change our understanding of information transfer and possibly render our current communication systems obsolete. Internally, the power source of these crafts remains one of the greatest mysteries. Traditional energy sources like fossil fuels, nuclear reactors, or even our most advanced batteries seem unlikely candidates. The craft's operations are silent, without any emissions or heat signatures. This might allude to a form of energy that's clean and incredibly efficient. Harnessing such an energy source could be the solution to our planet's growing energy needs and environmental concerns. Lastly, the UFO's ability to seemingly appear and disappear hints at dimensional or cloaking technology. While this is highly speculative, the idea that these crafts can phase in and out of detectability suggests technological advancements that challenge our understanding of space-time itself. The technological insights provided by Lazar's UFO evidence present a cornucopia of possibilities. These crafts, if genuine, encapsulate advancements that could drive multiple revolutions across various scientific and technological fields. The task ahead for the scientific community is monumental: to decode, understand, and hopefully harness the marvels that these UFOs present. Comparative analysis, past and present UFO claims. Over the years, countless claims of unidentified flying object, UFO sightings and encounters have graced both the annals of conspiracy theories and the databases of legitimate scientific inquiry. Bob Lazar's recent disclosure provides a unique opportunity to juxtapose past claims with the current revelation, allowing for a broader understanding of the phenomenon. In the early to mid-20th century, UFO sightings were largely anecdotal. Individuals often reported seeing strange lights in the sky, flying saucers, or cigar-shaped objects. These accounts were usually characterized by fleeting visuals, captured more in memory than on film. Such reports, while widespread, were difficult to verify due to the lack of tangible evidence. Most were dismissed as misidentifications of natural phenomena, aircraft or satellites, while others were attributed to overactive imaginations or hoaxes. However, certain past events stood out, such as the famous Roswell incident of 1947. An unidentified object crashed near Roswell, New Mexico, leading to widespread speculation about alien spacecraft and governmental cover-ups. Though officially dismissed as a weather balloon accident, Roswell remains a cornerstone of UFO folklore, reinforced by testimonies from individuals claiming to have seen extraterrestrial bodies and wreckage. Then there's the Rendlesham Forest incident of 1980 in the UK. Military personnel reported an encounter with an unknown craft, accompanied by physical evidence in the form of ground impressions and radiation readings. This incident remains one of the most well-documented UFO events, with multiple corroborating eyewitness accounts. Comparing these historical accounts with Lazar's recent disclosure, several points of convergence and divergence arise. The first notable aspect is the quality of evidence. While earlier claims were backed primarily by eyewitness testimonies and occasional blurry photographs, Lazara's revelation boasts clear images, videos, material samples, and corroborating documents. This progression could be attributed to advancements in technology, making capturing and preserving evidence easier, or it might indicate a more significant shift in the intentions of those behind the UFO phenomena, should they be of extraterrestrial origin. Another striking difference lies in the narrative surrounding the UFO claims. Earlier sightings were often isolated incidents, with limited continuity between separate events. With Lazara's disclosure, there seems to be a broader storyline, a narrative that speaks of consistent technology, intentions, and potential interactions. The UFOs in his evidence bear similarities in design and function, suggesting a common origin or purpose. On the other hand, the nature of the UFOs' movements across time has remained consistent. Accounts from decades ago, much like those presented by Lazara, describe aerial maneuvers that challenge our understanding of physics. The ability to hover, instant acceleration, and sharp turns without apparent inertia are hallmarks of both past and present claims. However, Lazar's revelation provides a more profound depth in technological understanding. Where past claims offered speculations on propulsion or energy sources, Lazara delves into specifics, suggesting potential mechanisms like element 115 and unique alloys. This level of detail, absent in many past claims, offers richer grounds for scientific investigation. The human reaction to these claims, though evolving, retains core similarities. Skepticism, awe, fear, and curiosity have been constant companions of UFO disclosures, from Roswell to today. However, with the mounting pile of evidence and the progression of technology validating certain aspects of these claims, contemporary society may be inching closer to a more open acceptance, or at least a more profound consideration of the UFO phenomenon. When Lazar's disclosure is placed within the historical continuum of UFO claims, it represents both a culmination of past narratives and a groundbreaking new chapter. While the core elements of mystery, wonder, and skepticism remain, the depth, clarity, and coherence of the present claims set them apart, nudging the world closer to potential answers about these enigmatic visitors, the skeptic's perspective debunking the evidence. While Bob Lazar's revelation has captivated many and bolstered the beliefs of UFO enthusiasts worldwide, it has equally drawn sharp criticism and skepticism from various quarters. The skeptic's lens, crucial in any scientific inquiry, attempts to probe, validate, and if necessary, debunk the presented evidence. Here's an exploration of the primary counterarguments that challenge Lazara's claims. In an age where digital technology can create hyper-realistic imagery, many skeptics argue that the photographs and videos presented by Lazar could be the result of sophisticated manipulation. Software advancements in visual effects and computer-generated imagery, CGI, have reached levels where distinguishing between reality and fabrication becomes exceedingly difficult. Without access to the original raw files and a comprehensive forensic analysis, the authenticity of the visual evidence remains questionable. Lazar's claim about the use of element 115 as a propulsion source for the UFOs has raised eyebrows in the scientific community. While element 115, or moscovium, is a real element, its known properties don't support the claims made. It's highly unstable with a brief half-life, making it an unlikely candidate for a sustainable propulsion system. Additionally, synthesizing it in significant quantities is currently beyond our technological grasp. Though the provided material samples are intriguing, skeptics argue that their origin and properties need rigorous independent verification. Without a transparent chain of custody and a clear understanding of their provenance, these samples could originate from various terrestrial sources. Claims about their levitation under specific conditions could also be results of controlled manipulations or misinterpretations. The leaked documents and testimonies, while sensational, are not beyond reproach. Historically, many supposed classified documents about UFOs have turned out to be hoaxes or misinterpretations. The anonymous nature of some testimonies further muddies the waters. Authenticating these documents and verifying the credentials of the testifiers are essential steps before taking these evidences at face value. Human psychology plays a significant role in UFO sightings and claims. Confirmation bias, where individuals interpret information in a way that confirms their pre-existing beliefs, can be a potent factor. Moreover, optical illusions, atmospheric phenomena, and even conventional aircraft can sometimes be misidentified as UFOs, especially when observed under unusual lighting or from specific angles. One would expect that with the frequent visits of these technologically advanced UFOs, astronomers and space agencies would have detected or observed some corroborating evidence by now. The vast network of telescopes, satellites, and space observatories constantly scanning the skies has so far provided no independent verification of the UFO phenomena at the scale suggested by Lazar. Historically, many UFO claims, even those that initially appeared robust, have been debunked over time. From misidentified weather balloons to misunderstood natural phenomena, there's a long track record of UFO claims that, under scrutiny, turned out to have mundane explanations. Skeptics argue that Lazar's claims could similarly be debunked as more information comes to light. While Lazara's evidence adds a compelling chapter to the UFO narrative, it's crucial to approach it with a balanced perspective. Skepticism, rooted not in disbelief but in the pursuit of truth, ensures that claims are rigorously tested and validated. Only through such scrutiny can the reality of the UFO phenomena, whatever it may be genuinely understood. The world's reaction, from believers to skeptics. When Bob Lazar unveiled his much-anticipated evidence of UFOs, the world was forced to sit up and take notice. The revelation, which had the potential to upend our understanding of our place in the universe, elicited a myriad of reactions. From firm believers to ardent skeptics, everyone had an opinion. Here's a panorama of the world's diverse responses. The believers, who had long awaited such a disclosure, felt vindicated. For them, Lazar's revelation was not just evidence, but confirmation of what they had believed for years, that we are not alone in the universe. Social media platforms exploded with excitement, with many sharing their own stories of sightings and encounters. UFO enthusiast groups saw an uptick in membership, and forums were abuzz with discussions dissecting every piece of evidence provided. Scientists and researchers, always in pursuit of the truth, approached the disclosure with a mix of curiosity and caution. Many called for a rigorous and transparent examination of the evidence, emphasizing the importance of peer review. Conferences, symposiums, and workshops were organized to discuss the implications of the evidence. If authenticated, the potential technological advancements inferred from the UFOs could open new avenues of research in fields like propulsion, energy, and material science. However, not everyone in the scientific community was as open to the revelation. Some scientists pointed to the history of UFO claims that were eventually debunked. For them, Lazar's evidence, however compelling, was just another chapter in the long saga of unproven assertions. They called for skepticism and warned against getting carried away by the sensationalism surrounding the disclosure. The general public's reaction was varied. For many, the revelation was a source of wonder and amazement. An affirmation of the age-old question of extraterrestrial life. Families gathered around television sets to watch specials and documentaries on the subject, and schools introduced discussions about UFOs and space exploration into their curriculum. Religious institutions and leaders around the world also weighed in. While some religious groups saw the evidence as challenging their scriptures and beliefs, others embraced it, interpreting the potential existence of extraterrestrial life as part of the divine plan. Debates about theology, the nature of God, and humanity's role in the universe became common in religious congregations. Governments and world leaders found themselves in a precarious position. The revelation demanded an official stance. While some governments acknowledged the evidence and called for international cooperation to understand the phenomenon better, others remained silent or dismissive. Conspiracy theories about governmental cover-ups, long associated with the UFO phenomenon, saw a resurgence, with many questioning the role of authorities in withholding or manipulating information about extraterrestrial encounters. The entertainment industry capitalized on the global interest. Movies, documentaries, and TV shows exploring the idea of UFOs and extraterrestrial life became immensely popular. Bookstores were filled with literature on the subject, ranging from scientific analyses to fictional tales of interstellar adventures. Yet, amid all the noise and excitement, there were those who remained indifferent. For a segment of the population, the disclosure, while interesting, did not impact their daily lives. They went about their routines, considering the UFO revelation as just another piece of news in an ever-churning cycle. Bob Lazar's disclosure became a mirror, reflecting the diverse beliefs, hopes, fears, and curiosities of humanity. It rekindled age-old debates about our existence and the mysteries of the universe, forcing the world to confront the vastness of the unknown and our place within it, the impact on science and aerospace research. Bob Lazar's disclosure, accompanied by its intricate web of claims, visuals, and purported technological marvels, set off a chain reaction in the world of science and aerospace research. The revelation, if authenticated, held the promise of upending several scientific paradigms and igniting a new era of aerospace innovation. Here's an examination of the ripple effects this disclosure had on various research spheres. Central to Lazar's claims was the alleged propulsion system of the UFOs, hinting at technologies and energy sources that, according to contemporary understanding, seemed next to impossible. Researchers were suddenly faced with the daunting task of reconciling observed UFO behaviors with existing laws of physics. This led to a renewed focus on areas like quantum mechanics, gravitation, and even the controversial field of anti-gravity research. Some theoretical physicists began reconsidering postulations around dark matter and dark energy, pondering if these cosmic enigmas might offer clues to the UFO propulsion riddle. The material samples touted by Lazar provided tantalizing hints of advanced metallurgical processes and potentially unknown elements or compounds. Laboratories around the world scrambled to analyze these samples, eager to uncover their secrets. If authentic, these materials promised to revolutionize industries far beyond aerospace, with potential applications in electronics, energy storage, and even medicine. The aerospace sector witnessed a resurgence of interest and investment. If the UFOs operated on principles yet unknown to us, then mastering these principles could lead to quantum leaps in aircraft and spacecraft design. Traditional propulsion systems, reliant on chemical fuels, might soon become obsolete, replaced by more efficient, sustainable, and perhaps even faster modes of transportation. The potential existence of technologically advanced extraterrestrial civilizations breathed new life into space exploration programs. If humans could comprehend and replicate the technology behind the UFOs, interstellar travel might shift from science fiction to reality. Plans to colonize other planets or moons, previously seen as distant goals, suddenly seemed achievable in the foreseeable future. This led to increased funding and interest in space agencies like NASA, ESA, and private entities like SpaceX and Blue Origin. While the potential advancements were exhilarating, they also ushered in waves of debates and challenges. How does one validate the claims made by Lazar, especially when they seemingly defied established scientific understanding? Peer review processes became more critical than ever. Skepticism surged in parallel with excitement, leading to polarized views within research communities. Some researchers even faced ethical dilemmas, torn between their desire to explore the new frontiers opened by the disclosure and their duty to uphold rigorous scientific standards. One positive outcome of the disclosure was the increased collaboration between nations and research institutions. Recognizing the magnitude of the potential breakthroughs at hand, many countries initiated joint research programs, pooling resources and expertise. This spirit of cooperation signaled a shift from isolated, competitive research to a more unified, collective quest for understanding. Bob Lazar's disclosure, regardless of its eventual validation, undeniably jolted the scientific and aerospace landscapes. It forced experts to question, reconsider, and even reinvent their fields of study. While the journey to deciphering the full truth behind the claims was fraught with challenges and debates, It undeniably propelled humanity a step closer to understanding the vast, mysterious cosmos that surrounds us.
Historic hearing on unidentified anomalous phenomena, also known as UFOs.
Yeah, the internet lighting up with questions over this video. Did the object come from the rocket or from somewhere else?
And alien ships have already visited our solar system.
Space has always been a source of wonder and mystery, capturing the imagination of many with unexplained phenomena. Unidentified flying objects, UFOs, have been a particularly intriguing aspect of this curiosity, sparking endless debates and theories. This intrigue is further fueled by frequent sightings near the International Space Station, ISS, a hub of scientific exploration that frequently catches glimpses of the unexplained. As mankind continues to reach for the stars, these mysteries remain a tantalizing and puzzling aspect of our exploration. NASA's stance on extraterrestrial phenomena. NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, has been at the forefront of space exploration and research since its establishment in 1958. With its ongoing missions and dedicated efforts to explore the cosmos, it is inevitably intertwined with the unexplained NASA's stance on unidentified flying objects, UFOs, and other mysterious phenomena, has always been an object of curiosity and sometimes even controversy. The organization has made significant efforts to research and explain these events scientifically. Their reactions often involve thorough investigation and analysis, relying on empirical data and known scientific principles. In many instances, NASA has provided rational explanations for sightings or events that initially appeared unexplainable. This often includes attributing them to known atmospheric conditions, reflections, or human-made debris. While these explanations are typically grounded in scientific observation, they sometimes clash with popular belief or expectations. NASA's commitment to the search for extraterrestrial life is evident in various missions and projects. From the Viking missions to Mars in the 1970s to the recent Perseverance rover, the agency's focus on finding signs of life beyond Earth is clear. Missions such as the Kepler Space Telescope, aimed at discovering Earth-like planets, further reinforce NASA's investment in the pursuit of extraterrestrial existence. While the organization has not found direct evidence of life beyond our planet, the discovery of exoplanets in the habitable zone and ongoing studies of Mars's geological and atmospheric conditions keep the question of extraterrestrial life an open and tantalizing prospect. Despite NASA's earnest scientific approach, there has been criticism of how the agency handles information regarding unexplained phenomena. Critics argue that there may be a lack of transparency, or that explanations are sometimes too hasty and dismissive of alternative possibilities. Conspiracy theories often surround these criticisms, with some individuals believing that NASA might be withholding information or evidence related to extraterrestrial life. These theories, while largely unfounded, persist in part because of the inherent mystery that surrounds the subject of extraterrestrials and the intense public interest in it. The criticism also highlights a broader societal challenge in communicating complex scientific information to the public. The gap between scientific expertise and public understanding can lead to mistrust or dissatisfaction with official explanations, especially on subjects as captivating and enigmatic as extraterrestrial phenomena. NASA's stance on extraterrestrial phenomena is a complex and multifaceted subject. Through rigorous scientific investigation, the agency strives to demystify space and foster understanding of the universe's many wonders. Yet, the elusive nature of extraterrestrial existence and the criticism surrounding NASA's handling of information remind us that space remains a realm filled with unanswered questions and enduring fascination. In the balance between science and the human imagination, the search for extraterrestrial life continues to be a compelling journey that challenges our perceptions and drives us to explore further. NASA's role in this journey is crucial, and its actions, explanations, and handling of information continue to shape our collective quest to unravel the universe's deepest mysteries. The 5,000 km wide object incident. The 5,000 km wide object incident refers to an intriguing and perplexing event that has captured the imagination of both scientists and the public alike. While the incident has inspired various theories and speculations, details remain scarce, leaving many unanswered questions. In the early 2000s, astronomers detected a mysterious object spanning approximately 5,000 kilometers in width in outer space. The immense size of the object, along with its erratic movements and transient appearances, immediately caught the attention of scientists worldwide. Initially, the object's discovery led to numerous speculations about its nature and origin. Was it a never-before-seen celestial body, or could it even be an artificial construct of an advanced extraterrestrial civilization? The question seemed endless, and the lack of concrete data only fueled the mystery. Further observation revealed that the object's behavior did not align with conventional astronomical phenomena. Its apparent ability to change direction and velocity defied explanation through known physics. Additionally, its intermittent visibility and seemingly intentional avoidance of detection added to the enigma. Scientific attempts to study the object faced challenges due to its elusive nature. Every time scientists believed they were closing in on answers, the object's behavior would change, evading classification and understanding. Many high-profile missions were organized to gather data, but the results were often inconclusive or contradictory. The incident inevitably led to various theories outside of mainstream scientific circles. Some argued that the object was proof of advanced extraterrestrial intelligence, while others believed it was a natural but unknown cosmic phenomenon. Skeptics raised questions about the validity of the observations themselves, suggesting potential errors or misinterpretations. Despite extensive research, the 5,000 km-wide object incident remains largely unexplained. The incident's lasting impact on science and popular culture reflects our collective fascination with the unknown and the unexplained. It stands as a testament to the limits of our understanding and the vast, mysterious universe that awaits exploration. As of now, the object has faded from observation, and its current whereabouts are unknown. The questions it raised linger, and its very existence continues to challenge conventional wisdom and ignite imaginations. It serves as a powerful reminder of how little we truly know about the universe and how much more there is to discover. Whether a natural phenomenon, an artificial construct, or something else entirely, the 5,000 km-wide object incident will likely remain a significant and puzzling chapter in the annals of astronomy and space exploration for years to come. Life and operations on the International Space Station. The International Space Station, ISS, serves as a testament to human innovation and collaboration in space exploration. Orbiting approximately 408 kilometers, 253 miles, above Earth, the ISS functions as a living laboratory where astronauts live, work, and conduct research. Life on the ISS is both fascinating and demanding. The environment is carefully controlled to sustain human life, but the absence of gravity poses unique challenges. Astronauts must adapt to weightlessness, which affects everything from simple daily tasks to complex scientific experiments. Each day on the ISS follows a structured routine, starting with morning briefings and moving on to assigned duties. These can include maintenance tasks, scientific experiments, exercise routines, and communication with mission control. The work can be mentally and physically taxing, and astronauts must be in peak condition to handle the demands of their roles. Nutrition and exercise play a crucial part in life on the ISS. Meals are carefully planned and packaged to provide the nutrients needed in space. Exercise is mandatory to counteract the effects of living in a low-gravity environment, as muscles and bones can weaken without regular use. Communication with family and friends on Earth is essential for mental well-being, and the internet allows for emails and video calls. Despite the isolation, astronauts often speak of a profound connection with humanity and the planet as they gaze upon Earth from their unique vantage point. The ISS is also a hub for groundbreaking scientific research. Experiments conducted on the station provide insights unattainable on Earth, contributing to fields such as medicine, engineering, and environmental science. The microgravity environment allows scientists to study phenomena in new ways, leading to discoveries and innovations that have far-reaching implications. International collaboration is at the heart of the ISS's success. Participating countries contribute resources, technology, and expertise to maintain and expand the station, This spirit of cooperation symbolizes a shared commitment to exploration and understanding. Yet, life on the ISS is not without risks. Space debris, mechanical failures, and the inherent hazards of space travel require constant vigilance. Safety protocols are rigorous, and astronauts train for various emergency scenarios. Even a small oversight can have significant consequences, underscoring the delicate balance of life and work in space. The ISS also plays a critical role in the long-term vision of human exploration beyond Earth's orbit. It serves as a testing ground for technologies and processes that will be vital for future missions to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. Lessons learned on the ISS inform plans and preparations for these ambitious undertakings. The International Space Station stands as a remarkable achievement in human history. It embodies the endless curiosity, ingenuity, and determination that drive us to explore the unknown. Life and operations on the ISS are a complex interplay of science, technology, human endurance, and international collaboration. The station continues to inspire and challenge, offering a glimpse into a future where the boundaries of our reach are continually expanding. Whether seeking answers to fundamental scientific questions or forging the path to other worlds, the ISS is a living symbol of what humanity can achieve when united by common goals and a sense of wonder. UFO sightings and controversies. The topic of unidentified flying objects, UFOs, has long captured the public's imagination and sparked endless debates and controversies. Ranging from mere curiosities to matters of national security, UFO sightings have become a complex subject, both fascinating and perplexing. Historically, UFO sightings date back centuries, with accounts found in various ancient texts and artworks. However, the modern era of UFO fascination began in the mid-20th century, coinciding with the onset of the Space Age and the Cold War. Sightings increased, and stories spread, leading to the formation of numerous civilian and governmental groups tasked with investigating these mysterious phenomena. Many UFO sightings can be attributed to natural or human-made objects, such as weather balloons, satellites, aircraft, or celestial events. Misinterpretations and hoaxes have further muddied the waters, leading to skepticism and dismissal by many scientists and officials. However, some cases remain unexplained and continue to intrigue researchers and enthusiasts alike. The U.S. government's stance on UFOs has shifted over time. Initially dismissive, various agencies have conducted investigations, most famously Project Blue Book, which ran from 1952 to 1969. Though it concluded that most sightings were explainable, a small percentage remained unaccounted for, fueling further speculation and controversy. Media coverage has played a significant role in shaping public perception of UFOs. Sensationalist reports, movies, and documentaries have contributed to a cultural phenomenon, with the term UFO often synonymous with extraterrestrial life. This association has led to polarized opinions, with some viewing the subject with curiosity and open-mindedness, while others dismiss it as pseudoscience or conspiracy theory. In recent years, there has been a notable shift in the discussion around UFOs. High-profile sightings by military personnel, along with declassified documents and videos, have brought renewed attention and credibility to the subject. Governments around the world, including the U.S., have begun to take a more transparent and serious approach to investigating these unexplained phenomena. One of the most significant developments occurred in 2020 when the U.S. Department of Defense established the Unidentified Aerial Phenomena, UAP, Task Force to investigate sightings by military personnel. Subsequent reports acknowledged the existence of objects displaying advanced technology and flight characteristics that defy current understanding. These admissions have led to calls for further research and potential implications for national security. The controversies surrounding UFO sightings extend beyond government actions and public perception. Ethical concerns have arisen regarding transparency, misinformation, and the potential manipulation of public opinion. The delicate balance between national security interests and the public's right to know adds another layer of complexity to the ongoing debate. The subject of UFOs also intersects with broader societal issues, reflecting cultural anxieties technological advancements, and philosophical questions about humanity's place in the universe. It challenges conventional scientific paradigms and encourages a re-evaluation of our understanding of the known world. UFO sightings and controversies represent a multifaceted and evolving subject that continues to captivate and challenge. The shifting landscape, marked by increased transparency, serious investigation, and public engagement, indicates a turning point in how these phenomena are approached and understood. While answers remain elusive, the quest for understanding continues to inspire, provoke, and remind us of the mysteries that lie beyond our earthly bounds. Whether one views UFOs with skepticism or wonder, they undeniably hold a unique place in our collective consciousness, embodying both the known and the unknown, and reflecting our eternal desire to explore and comprehend the uncharted realms of existence. The Roswell Incident and Area 51. The Roswell Incident and the enigmatic Area 51 have become synonymous with UFO lore, conspiracy theories, and government secrecy. These two interconnected subjects have fueled public imagination and intrigue for decades, resulting in countless books, documentaries, and movies. In July 1947, a mysterious crash near Roswell, New Mexico, made headlines. Initially reported as a captured flying saucer, the U.S. military quickly retracted the statement, claiming the object was a weather balloon. However, the swift change in narrative and the military's involvement sparked suspicion and gave birth to various conspiracy theories. Witnesses, including military personnel, later came forward with accounts of strange debris and even allegations of recovered alien bodies. The Roswell incident has since become a cultural touchstone, symbolizing the potential cover-up of extraterrestrial contact. The lack of definitive evidence, coupled with conflicting accounts, has allowed the Roswell narrative to evolve and take on a life of its own. It has inspired a dedicated community of researchers and enthusiasts seeking the truth behind the incident. Area 51, a U.S. Air Force facility located in the Nevada desert, has become equally emblematic of secrecy and the unknown. Officially acknowledged as a test site for experimental aircraft and weapons systems, Area 51's remote location and restricted access have fueled speculation about its true purpose. Allegations of UFO sightings, advanced technology, reverse engineering, and collaboration with extraterrestrials have transformed Area 51 into a symbol of mystery and intrigue. The connection between the Roswell incident and Area 51 was popularized by individuals claiming to have worked at the facility, who alleged that debris and alien remains from Roswell were transported to Area 51 for study. These claims, though largely unsubstantiated, have been embraced by UFO enthusiasts and conspiracy theorists, further intertwining the two subjects. The impact of the Roswell incident and Area 51 on popular culture cannot be overstated. They have inspired a wide array of artistic and literary works, reflecting societal fascination with the unknown and the potential existence of intelligent life beyond Earth. They have also prompted serious inquiry, with researchers and journalists attempting to separate fact from fiction and uncover the truth behind the legends. Government responses to inquiries about Roswell and Area 51 have been characterized by ambiguity and avoidance, often leading to more questions than answers. While the Air Force released a report in 1997 attempting to dispel Roswell's myths by attributing the incident to a top-secret balloon project, many remain unconvinced. Area 51's continued secrecy and limited public information have further perpetuated its enigmatic status. The allure of the Roswell incident and Area 51 extends beyond mere curiosity or entertainment. They raise fundamental questions about transparency, accountability, and the public's right to know. They challenge the boundaries of scientific understanding and provoke philosophical reflections on humanity's place in the cosmos. Moreover, they provide a lens through which to examine broader cultural and political dynamics, including trust in government, the role of media, and the human propensity for myth-making. The Roswell incident and Area 51 represent more than just historical events or locations. They are cultural phenomena reflecting the complexities and contradictions of the human condition. They embody our longing for discovery, our fear of the unknown, and our persistent drive to uncover hidden truths. They also serve as cautionary tales, reminding us of the power of narrative, the fragility of truth, and the importance of critical thinking in a world where fact and fiction are often indistinguishable. Whether viewed as historical mysteries, cultural artifacts, or existential riddles, these subjects continue to captivate, challenge, and inspire, transcending their origins to become enduring symbols of our collective quest for understanding and meaning. Discovery of Interstellar Visitor, Oumuamua. The discovery of Oumuamua, an interstellar object that passed through our solar system, marked a significant milestone in astronomy. Detected on October 19, 2017, by the Pan-STARRS 1 telescope in Hawaii, Oumuamua's high-speed and hyperbolic trajectory quickly indicated that it originated from outside the solar system. Its unique characteristics and unexpected appearance set off a flurry of excitement, curiosity, and scientific inquiry. Unlike typical solar system objects, Oumuamua's shape, behavior, and motion did not conform to conventional expectations. Its elongated form, estimated to be about 10 times longer than it is wide, was unlike anything previously observed in the solar system. The object's rapid rotation and lack of visible comet-like tail added to its enigmatic nature. Observations of Oumuamua were challenging due to its rapid passage through the solar system. Astronomers worldwide scrambled to collect as much data as possible before the object moved out of reach. Even with limited time and information, researchers were able to discern several key attributes, such as its reddish hue, indicative of cosmic radiation exposure, and its lack of visible ice or water vapor. The absence of a visible tail or coma, typically associated with comets, initially led some to classify Oumuamua as an asteroid. However, subsequent analysis revealed that it exhibited a slight, unexpected acceleration as it moved away from the Sun. This non-gravitational motion could not be explained by conventional forces alone and prompted speculation about various causes, including the possibility of outgassing, where internal materials evaporate and produce thrust. The nature and origin of Oumuamua sparked widespread interest and debate within the scientific community and beyond. Some proposed that it might be a fragment of a larger object, torn apart by gravitational forces during a close encounter with a star. Others suggested that it could be a cosmic dust bunny, a fluffy aggregate of tiny particles held together by gravity. Theories ranged from the mundane to the extraordinary, with some even positing that Oumuamua might be an artificial probe sent by an extraterrestrial civilization. While the more sensational explanations for Oumuamua's behavior captured public imagination, most astronomers favor natural explanations. The lack of concrete evidence for artificial origins, combined with the vastness of space and the likelihood of interstellar objects passing through the solar system, makes a natural origin more plausible. However, the limited data and Oumuamua's rapid exit from the solar system left many questions unanswered, ensuring that its true nature remains a subject of fascination and speculation. The detection of Oumuamua also had profound implications for our understanding of solar system dynamics and interstellar space. It provided direct evidence that objects from other star systems can and do enter our solar system, opening new avenues of study and challenging existing models of solar system formation and evolution. The encounter with Oumuamua demonstrated the need for advanced observation techniques and preparedness to study transient interstellar visitors, as they offer unique insights into distant star systems and the broader universe. In the wake of Oumuamua's discovery, astronomers have continued to search for additional interstellar objects, recognizing their potential to expand our knowledge of the cosmos. The experience with Oumuamua underscored the importance of international collaboration, rapid response, and adaptability in the face of unexpected discoveries. It also sparked interest in potential missions to intercept or study future interstellar objects, recognizing the value of direct, in-depth analysis. The brief but momentous visit of Oumuamua serves as a reminder of the vast, unexplored frontiers of space and the potential for unexpected discoveries that challenge conventional wisdom. It underscores the importance of curiosity, open-mindedness, and scientific rigor in the quest to understand the universe. Whether viewed as a scientific anomaly, a harbinger of future discoveries, or a symbol of the infinite possibilities of space exploration, Oumuamua's legacy endures, inspiring awe, wonder, and a renewed commitment to unlocking the mysteries of the cosmos. Reflection on the search for extraterrestrial life. The search for extraterrestrial life is a profound and complex endeavor that has captivated humanity for generations. This journey, fueled by curiosity and determination, has led to remarkable advancements in science and technology, revealing previously unimagined aspects of the universe. From the mysterious phenomena near the International Space Station to the intriguing passage of interstellar objects like Oumuamua, the continuous exploration of the cosmos has uncovered more questions than answers. Institutions such as NASA have been both praised and criticized for their handling of these inquiries. Events like the Roswell incident and the enigmatic Area 51 have ignited imaginations, leading to a blend of scientific investigation, public fascination, and conspiracy theories. The endeavor to understand life beyond Earth is not confined to the examination of distant galaxies or mysterious occurrences alone. The International Space Station serves as a testament to human capability, collaboration, and persistence in exploring the unknown. The operations on the ISS provide valuable insights into the challenges and possibilities of life beyond our planet. Understanding the complexities of interstellar objects, studying the potential habitats for life on distant planets, and comprehending the vastness of the universe are monumental tasks. Yet, the pursuit continues, driven by the inherent human desire to explore and understand. Recent advancements in technology, combined with international collaboration, are bringing us closer to answering some of the most fundamental questions. Are we alone in the universe? Is there life on other planets? What does the existence or non-existence of extraterrestrial life mean for humanity? While definitive answers to these questions remain elusive, the journey itself is invaluable. The search for extraterrestrial life fosters innovation, encourages critical thinking, promotes cross-disciplinary collaboration, and inspires the next generation of scientists, thinkers, and dreamers. In reflecting on the search for extraterrestrial life, it is essential to recognize not only the scientific milestones and controversies, but also the broader implications. This quest transcends science, touching on philosophy, ethics, art, and culture. It challenges our perceptions of ourselves and our place in the cosmos, provoking deep contemplation about our responsibilities, our potential, and the nature of existence itself.